Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Connor. I'm here with my father.
Come on.
And today, it is, well, it's around the Halloween season. It's not exactly Halloween when we're filming this. How many days out are we?
We're 2 days out.
Before Halloween.
2 days, yeah.
And we are doing one of the most highly requested artists on the channel.
Since the start of this channel.
Yeah, I think so.
Yep, everybody.
I think on the first video, the Radiohead video, someone was like, show your dad Death Grips. You were like, man, this music's so peaceful. I love this Radiohead album. Show him Death Grips.
Yeah, and then I got worried. I was like, what is Death Grips?
This is their debut album. They had a mixtape before this. So this is their 2012 record, I believe, 2012. The Money Store. You haven't heard much about... You've heard a lot about Death Grips, but you haven't heard much of their music. You've heard one song that we did on Patreon. And it was off one of their newer records. What was it? What did we do? Hothead. We did Hothead.
That's right.
And you liked it.
I liked it. It did. It appealed to my heavy metal roots.
Yes, and you're not just saying that because of...
growing up I was a metalhead, so
track number one, Get Got.
Get got blood rushed in my head, they hot lock popping off the fucking block, not clocking wristlet watch been top off. Dragon volume blasting, bailing out my brain. Red light flash, dim stop I smash. Abraxas, hydroplane, massive anywhere. Losing my set, I get the stairs when I'm looking at. Wasn't there, wasn't there, wasn't there, wasn't there. Get got blood rushed in my head. They hot lock popping off the fucking block. Not clocking wristed, watch been top. I fly inside that watch and big size, snips, I put it when he quits out.
Chorus is really fucking cool, eh?
It's catchy.
Yeah, really good. I love that sample there.
This one?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, there's a few samples.
Like, it's an Indian feeling. I'm getting an Indian feeling. I'm just fixing my hair.
I believe it's from this Middle Eastern sample. I forget what it is exactly, but we'll watch a sample video after the song or after the album.
See, that was really, really cool, man. And you know what? I'm going to tell you. I don't know. Maybe the rest of the songs are going to... my head will blow up and I'll throw up or something. I don't know, like people have been saying. But
yeah.
You know when you watch... When somebody tells you about a comedy thing and then or a horror movie and it's so fucking scary that you're going to die?
Yeah.
And then you watch it? See, for me, this is like right up my alley.
Yeah, people were saying that this is going to like... Oh, your dad's going to fucking shit and fucking start shaking. And it's going to freak him out. But so you probably hyped it up so high, like
this I did.
Is
I thought
fucking scare me. It's gonna be something.
Well, like I said, I thought it was gonna be that splish splosh, you know,
like fucking. Track number two, The Fever, AA.
This is cool. Their choruses are really good, man.
Yeah, they got catchy choruses.
I gotta say, they got really catchy choruses. I don't know about Black Goat Anus. There's a real fucking hypnotic thing about their music, man.
Yeah.
This is crazily appealing to me more than anybody I think would think. You know that?
Okay, that's The Fever.
You know that?
It's appealing to me
way more than what any like everybody I assuming, or maybe everybody just said it to to that your dad's going to love it. Because well,
I think a lot of people were sending it expecting you to not like it.
It's the complete opposite, man.
Because it is very hit or miss for people, and I think you can see why. Yeah, no, I think a lot of people probably thought that you would enjoy it, and then a lot of people thought you wouldn't. But you said a lot of these elements in the tracks are appealing to you.
Well, you know what? It's the industrial, like it's like the stuff that I grew up with in Vancouver, like Skinny Puppy and that. I like that, right? Mm-hmm. I love that element, right?
Track number 3, Lost Boys.
Ooh, that's nice. Oh my God, it sounds like big industrial electro, yeah. You know, where they make electricity.
Yeah.
What are those things are called? Yeah. I like the vocals right there. Yeah. Right? I like to hear his vocals all the way like that. This is that real fucking dystopian soundtrack.
Yes. Yeah.
The timing is really fucking me up, eh?
Is it?
Well, just it's so...
It's just very hypnotic to me.
Yeah, yeah. No, maybe that's... I was like... That was, yeah, a very dystopian fucking feeling in that song about, you know, especially they're, you know, being on the outskirts of town and all that kind of shit. All I picture is like... Again, blown up buildings and darkness and you know what I mean?
Yeah, no, I totally get that. And those electricity towers that you're talking about.
Yeah, and there you can see them going
back and forth.
And shit's coming and there's smoke everywhere and there's fucking just chaos.
People screaming and shit and fucking, yeah.
You stick your thumb through that hole, eh?
Is that what you do?
Or something else.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a hole right here, so
yeah, you could put
you could hang it there.
You could actually. You stick your
wiener
through there to hold it up.
You'd have to if you went like for a costume party though. You'd have to keep it hard the whole night to.
You'd need like
six Viagras,
right?
Yeah, to keep it going. Track number 4, Blackjack.
Fuck. Yeah, I'm glad I have lyrics in this.
Oh, you wouldn't get any if you didn't have
No, I know. I wouldn't know what this is about. Okay, this one's actually fucking up my head.
A little bit?
Yeah, it is. Like,
the timing and stuff?
Yeah, I would not want to be hammered listening to this trying to go to sleep.
Yeah, so that's Blackjack.
That was pushing it for me into the weird, completely like fucking... I don't know, like really, really drunk, somebody repeatedly slapping me in the face in a fucking bathtub of ice cold water with a strobe light on while dogs are pissing on me.
That's what it felt like?
Yeah.
Yeah, no.
Like, so,
why'd you have to add dogs pissing on you? And what kind of dogs are these?
People dressed as dogs.
Oh, okay, not real dogs.
Not real dogs.
If it were real dogs, so what type of dog would you?
Those little ones, the like wiener dogs.
Yeah, no, that's one of the ones that I'd say it's, you know, a less catchy track.
You know who I actually look like right now a little bit?
Who?
More of my hair and stuff is John 5, or the guy I showed you. The guitar player with those cats you love. You love those cats, don't you?
I fucking hate those cats.
Skinless cats.
It's not skinless. Hairless.
I thought they were skinless cats.
Imagine a skinless cat.
Ooh, what would it have?
I don't know.
Ooh.
it wouldn't work. It would fucking be like, it would all collapse. Okay, let's go to the next track. Okay. Hustle Bones.
Boneless cats. Okay. Oh, it must be like Hustle Bones. Like in a cup. Fuck what you heard, yeah, fuck what you heard. But it's real shit, kick your whole dick to the top. What? But you don't hear me though. Hustle Bones coming out my mouth. Hustle Bones coming out my mouth. Oh, this is cool. this is the one I... Hustle Bones coming out my mouth. Coming out my mouth. That knock a cop off unconscious. More dog cocktail is out by my skin. That line of chalk round round the clock. Too many more drop to count the steel. I love that, eh?
This chorus here.
No, that.
Oh.
Hear the kick drum?
Yeah.
Whoa! Yeah, like. I love the criminal intent, how he brings it in. Ah, Hustle Bones. Hustle Bones is good, Connor.
That's a fun one.
That's a really fun one, man. That I'm glad we went to this from the other track.
Blackjack.
Yeah, because it just Blackjack just... That was... Fuck, it was well-wrapped, man.
Yeah, no. Like
it was well, totally well-packaged. Really, really good chorus. Really good mixing. His vocals were a little bit louder for me. That whole bass drum going.
Yeah, that was fucking intense.
I know.
Yeah,
that was really cool.
With a really cool sample, the you know electronic sound. Everything about that track is just really fun.
One thing I want to ask though is like, I've seen some messages that came through from people saying that the drummer is like insane, but I haven't really heard him.
Not on this record, no.
No, eh?
You won't hear too much crazy drumming on this.
Okay, because I'm hearing more programming right now.
Yeah, but... yeah. I mean, he was used on this record, and then he also, you know, he was there for, he would do, recreate all this live.
Like, oh, okay,
for
okay.
The live shows and
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
But the later records, he's a lot more prominent.
Oh, okay,
I'm thinking about their last two albums and then some EPs they've done and some longer EPs.
Yeah.
He's very prominent on there. Track number 6. I've Seen Footage.
This is the clearest so far.
Yeah.
Like... I don't even know what that sound is.
It sounds like a guitar, but I don't know.
Yeah.
This chorus is, yeah, definitely the most accessible.
For sure, yeah. You know, I just got a feeling of like, calling this like punk hip hop.
Yeah, it is.
It is?
For sure, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Is that, what is that? Is that voice?
Yeah, I think so.
That's you can see, that's the most catchiest.
Yeah.
And accessible is what they're saying.
Yeah, on Genius.
On Genius,
accessible.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's hands down.
I got to pull my tattoos down, sorry, guys.
I think that's hands down the most accessible on the album. One of the most accessible Death Grip songs in general.
I really felt in the middle of there when in the lyrics of the verse number 2, I really, not just because of those lyrics, but I felt very punk rock.
Track number 7, Double Helix.
Ooh, that sounds like...
clock. A really distorted clock.
It's got that electric sound to it.
This
again.
Is really neat, man.
I love the double double.
Yeah.
I know, I'm talking Tim Hortons. Sorry.
I like double doubles too.
Yeah. I really like the Sonics in here.
Well, and MC Ride has such a great flow.
Yeah.
Underrated flow. Like the way he's over to, able to flow over fucking the weirdest time signatures and shit. Damn, well, I never thought, oh yeah, like I did, no, wake up, young blood. Break it.
See, really wanna know, I'll break it. Double, double helix. Wow, that was good, man.
You like that one?
I really like that one. I love that. I love his where he's, how he just breaks the double. Like double, it's a hard stop, double. And then that,
there.
This is very... I know people, you know, my mom say, and your mom and stuff like that, but I could probably sleep to this.
How?
I know, you know.
Like, if it stayed the same, like that loop, the instrumental loop, you
this
think?
Song right here, like the whole thing, I would sleep to it in, like.
If it was just an instrumental or even with MC Ride?
With MC Ride, with him going.
Mm.
Like, you know, I don't know.
So if it just went on for an hour, like you could probably fall asleep.
I could fall asleep. Like it's for
it's
me,
so hypnotic.
It's the hypnotic, and it's like it's not overbearing. Was not overbearing at all. There wasn't
that jars out, except for towards the end. I think there's one sample that comes.
Well,
in.
Well, I thought that was a cool switch.
It was pretty cool, yeah.
Because it took you away, and you're like it's like somebody you're there, and somebody fucking slaps you in the face, and you went,
whoa,
what the fuck?
And then
where
they
am I?
Pull you right back.
Then, but whoa, and then you're right back into it, right?
Yeah.
I really like that track, Double Helix.
Track number 8. System Blower.
Let's get you know what I'm saying? You look up, bragging about how you had it all down, but what's up now when your shit is done? How I'm coming, where I'm slinging, where I'm running, what I'm bringing. Tell you, cause it's best I'm sleeping, cause I'm busting for no reason and random murder, killing season.
His vocals are up higher.
You're reading my balls. Yeah. I was just gonna say, it's but way higher. But now when hard me black raping, full chest
whirring through your bleeding. System burning, to his knees, I'm begging for mercy while I'm leaning. Hard to the left,
and the crack in the grip, to the head, bucket, to the head, knock whip. Fuck, I really like this track, right?
It's cool.
Yeah. That's really good there.
That's blow.
Yeah.
That's blow part, yeah.
You don't want to hear this song as the sound man, eh? If these guys are going to play.
Oh, yeah.
System blower.
Yeah.
We're going to blow the system at the sound check.
Shit is system blower.
Oh, that's I was gonna say the train chopped up. Oh my god, it's weird.
it's
so weird to hear it during like chopped up like that. Feels like we're going on the train, doesn't it?
Yeah.
System Blower.
That's a cool one.
Very cool. You know, okay, so this one and... Helix. Double Helix is when the vocal started coming out.
Yeah.
Which is about the halfway point, right?
Yeah, after I've seen footage.
Yeah. Yeah. So seven, yeah. So six. Wait, how many tracks do we have? 12?
13,
yeah. System Blower is fantastic. Love the nod. Anybody watching who doesn't know what we're talking about in terms of the SkyTrain in Vancouver here, we have the SkyTrain in the Lower Mainland.
And it makes that exact sound.
And it makes that exact sound.
So that is whatever. So that is the Death Grip sample. This isn't the Vancouver one though. That's
Vancouver.
Oh, that's specifically Vancouver.
Yeah, sounds of Vancouver SkyTrain. And then somebody wrote the first one was we came to blow your system.
Track number 9, The Cage.
I like how they pick the like ominous notes.
Yeah.
They're not picking like major scale stuff all the time. Oh, what is
it? I think these are analog drums.
These sound like real drums, yeah. You hear the double kick too, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah, I got that man for sure, but tell him why you had to get him now. That was cool.
Yeah.
Wow, I just had to, you don't probably didn't see because I got glasses on, but I closed my eyes for a big chunk of that, really listening to that. And the thing that I was, one common thing that was coming out was like, I was back playing a tabletop video game at an arcade.
That's the feeling that sound brought.
Yes. And then it's like, and then the chaos. And then, so the background stuff for me was, I'm fucking weird. I don't know why I say this shit, but this is how I felt.
Okay.
Tabletop like this, right?
Yes.
In the old arcades. And I'm sitting there going like this. And that sound is the musical score on the video game. And the chaos and shit is me going around shooting. Yeah. And I got my finger like this. I'm fucking going, oh, and I'm looking like this, right? And please don't make this a thumbnail. Like this.
But that's what you imagined.
That's what I meant. Yeah. That one. Yeah. That one was, I enjoyed the previous one more.
System Blower.
Yeah. That was really closer to that. This one was good.
Track number 10. Punk Weight.
That sped up a lot, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Pitched up and sped up.
Oh, I like this segue here. Hot shit. Damn shit. Okay, motherfucker, let's do this. I really like when he breaks for the vocals.
Yeah. And there's no instrumental.
Yeah. Even this here.
Yeah.
Right? Oh, this is cool. Whoa. That bottom end is fucking killer, eh?
Yeah. Okay. It's Punk Weight.
Fuck, man, I have to, you know what? It's, I have to tell you though, man.
It's working for you?
It was working for me.
Yeah, I'm actually really happy that
it's really working for me. Like, I can't,
I was worried. I was a little bit worried because I didn't know how, you know, this would obviously, you know, work for, like, because you can see why people do have trouble listening to this. It's not,
oh, for sure.
It's not easily accessible at all, for sure.
Yeah. But then you know what? I grew up when electronic was, you know, in the 80s when heavy, grungy electronic was out, right?
Yeah.
And growing up on that. So, for me, it's not so far from where that comes from. The one thing I like though is that in this specifically in this track is that, and I've said it many times with you, is that when stuff is too much, and they repeat it too much in the same form,
it
gets boring. But taking these even
like a quick second.
4 second break, 2 second break, stop. And
changing the beat just a little bit for like it, four bars or something.
Yeah,
and then going back to it.
It gives the listener just
enough time to breathe.
Yeah, and you know what? It's like, just think of it as this, okay? As a roller coaster. Mm-hmm. If it all went in fucking circles, you'd hate it.
Yeah.
But when it goes up like this, and there's a harsh circle, and then there's a nice curve.
Yeah.
And they all wait. Right? Yeah. That's
actually a really good analogy.
Yeah, because that's
one of your best I think you've ever had.
What, that one there?
That analogy, yeah.
Well, you feel it. You're like, you're this, and we're getting ready for that thing, and you and I are in our seats, and we're joking. We just had some food around the thing like that.
Hopefully not some food.
Yeah. Yeah, a bunch of food, and we're cruising, and we're just going down like this, and then we hit that first corner, right? And then we're going, and we start turning. You can turn sideways too. Let's pretend. Why not? We start turning sideways.
Well, how am I going to predict which way you're going?
You just follow me, and then we go like, and we're going to go hard right, super fast, right? Whoa!
Yeah. Track number 11.
Fuck that.
Let me say it properly.
Okay.
Without you interrupting.
I thought we were doing it together, like rappers. Okay, we'll do one. Let's just try one where I do it like the call out of a rapper. Go, ready?
Okay, track number 11. Fuck that.
This is a crazy change, eh?
Yeah.
I like my sure beta 58A has matted. No, fuck that. Broke off his axis, polar shifted granite. Not made to offer, realized bitch on this planet. Hey, I gotta say what you said earlier. Kudos to him for going over top of this beat.
Yeah.
I know it's got the clap and stuff, but it's still a. I don't know. You know what? That for me, that beat right there, it sounds like when the fucking lady goes and puts the thing on the woman's stomach, and you hear the heartbeat.
Oh, for pregnancy?
Yeah, yeah. I think that's what it makes me go feel cozy. Like you know,
you can fall asleep.
Yeah, you can hear the liquids and you hear the heartbeat.
That does not make me feel cozy. Yeah, it's got a liquidy sound to it, this beat.
Yes, liquidy and wet.
Yeah, no, but I couldn't sleep to it.
The fucking boggles. Kudos, Matt. Like, is it MC Ride?
MC Ride.
MC Ride. He, man, to keep it, and first off, and to remember those patterns.
Oh, yeah, when he performs.
When
live.
He performs, yeah. Yeah, like yeah. That's.
I'll have to show you some live performances. They're pretty insane.
Yeah.
I'll show you videos afterwards.
I'm fucking, no shit. I'm really, really digging this album.
Track number 12, Bitch Please.
Ooh. Whoa. Really good.
That's cool.
Really good mix again, man.
Yeah.
It's got from track 7 down. It's
mixes.
Yeah,
amazing. Yeah.
Turn her down and kick it to the curb. Shut it down. Yeah.
That
was like a drum fill, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, look at the little verb on there, right?
Yeah.
Sure. Oh, hear that?
Yeah.
Fuck, that song goes hard. That was really good. That was the clearest track on this.
In terms of mixing.
In terms of mixing, yeah. The cleanest. I'm not saying that's the thing. Like we talked about earlier. The earlier tracks, they're meant to be that way. It wasn't like a mistake or something like that. But in terms of clarity overall, that was really clear and a banging track.
Yeah, no.
Really, really good. Fantastic. And then that... It's super catchy as well.
Track 13, Hacker.
My God, this sounds nice. It sounds like what I wanted to record.
Yeah.
Hey, no ins and outs.
Oh, someone's party.
You come out, your shit is gone. Bitch. Going back to Tangier. With some drones and a spear. They do the same thing. Grab your fucking chair.
Fuck, wow.
Everybody's like...
Holy shit.
I got this pregnant snake. I'm crazy surrounded by long hair.
This is cool, Connor.
Make you want a break in the Apple Store. Think a swim, still on the way. Big away.
Is this more like their newer stuff?
Kind of, yeah. It's such a good closer to the album.
Yeah.
It's so good.
Yo, cats and JPEG to the head. Uber Rates, you're an intern. A WikiLeaks. Most loved, therefore most hated. 13 times out of 11. Your bad ideas are the ATM. Oh, I love that, Connor.
Yeah.
It's so... Try to go fuck that nautical. Teaching bitches how to swim. Oh, this one's my fucking going down is one of my faves. This is so good, man.
So cool.
It's so good. Oh, man. This...
Yeah.
I love the singing part, man.
It's, yeah. I know the first three numbers.
Holy shit! Hacker! What a closer, man.
Yeah.
Wow. That's the way you close out an album. Fuck.
So now you know Death Grips.
That's... I like the... I'm... Man. I like Death Grips, man. Hacker. Well, okay. I got to just say, that was... From track 7 onward, we started to get clearer, clearer vocally. It's like I'm gonna use an analogy again, but it ain't gonna be food, okay?
Okay.
It's like a dirty window,
and you're cleaning it,
and you're cleaning it, and you're slowly cleaning it on track 1, and it's fucking got a little bit of shit, and then you slow, and you get to track 7, and you start getting clearer, 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 and then you close out.
It's like polishing.
You've polished your window, because that was a fucking absolutely clear, polished. Hit fucking dance number. Yeah,
that is, I think, the fan favorite off this album.
Yeah.
Most people, I know I've seen footage the most accessible, and Get Got is very, you know, like pop, like known amongst people. But I think that is the one that most people would say is their, you know, fan favorite.
That just shows, okay, that they can do, that they are capable of doing anything then.
Pretty much.
No,
yeah.
Like really, like a really good, catchy, lyrically fucking brilliant song.
Cool. Well, I'm glad you enjoyed it. This is probably a good place to end off the video. I had a lot of fun tonight. It's nighttime that we're filming this.
Yeah.
You have fun?
I had an absolute blast. And I'll just tell you, I had a rough day today. I didn't feel good at all. And then I had a turnaround and ended up being able to film. So I just thank you for watching, and thank you for sitting here and entertaining me again. And
yeah, and I hope you guys enjoyed.
Yeah.
This video should be up on Halloween. So, you know, if you celebrate Halloween, I hope you have a great Halloween. Let us know if you did dress up over the weekend. What did you dress up as? Or if you're dressing up today, let us know your costumes.
And another thing, let us know in the comments if you think that tonight... Connor's mom and I are going to...
Okay. Stay safe, guys.
Take care. Bye-bye.